Hello everybody, my name is Pat Yusho, and welcome to a Nintendo Direct prediction video. So yeah, I have a special guest with me today. Please introduce yourself, sir.
Hey guys, this is Unitastic. Hi.
Okay guys.
Yeah, thanks for having me on here.
No problem. So, yeah. Okay guys, so today, of course, we're gonna be doing our predictions of what's gonna be coming, what's gonna be, you know, shown off at the Nintendo Direct. Well, when this is uploaded a few hours from now. So, why don't you start, Nam? What do you think is gonna be shown off?
My first thing is, I'm pretty sure they're gonna do Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. There's been a lot of rumors, and I've seen a few videos from Game Explain saying, oh, guys, they're gonna do Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. And I'm pretty sure if they're gonna do this, they're most likely gonna do like an amiibo collection. I purchased from Game Explain, so it's like yeah. If they've done this on the eShop data mining, then I'm pretty sure this is probably gonna happen. So yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I never actually played Twilight Princess, and I was trying to find a copy of it at at my local game shop.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat as you.
Yeah, I could find Wind Waker, but not Twilight Princess. Just like, I don't have a Wii U yet, so, or I might not get one until, like, the NX, so,
Yeah, I might as well just, I'm probably gonna go straight to the NX right when Wii U comes out. I mean, right when it comes out.
So, one of my predictions is that they might show off Shin Megami Tensei 4 Final, because it was recently announced for Japan like at least a month ago, I think, or two months ago. Yeah, and I believe it's coming out of Japan in February. So, and with Atlas and their localization thing, I'm thinking it might release sometime either fall or winter 2016.
I think we're gonna have a early winter release.
Maybe when was the original SMT4 came out?
I actually never played Shin Megami Tensei 4, so I don't really know too much. I've always been a Persona. I've always been a spin-off guy, like Persona, and actually starting next year, I'm going to try to get more into the original series, like Shin Megami Tensei, and also trying to get into the new Fire Emblem Shin Megami Tensei crossover. That's kind of a little segue to my second prediction. So.
Okay.
Yeah, but I've seen a few videos talking about Shin Megami Tensei 4 Final. Apparently, this is takes place after Shin Megami Tensei 4, but it's in a kind of a weird canon. So yeah, I really hope they show it off tomorrow, because it's gonna be really interesting on how they kind of place this after Persona 4 Shin Megami Tensei 4. So it's gonna be in a weird zone.
Yeah, I think I'm on the it came out the original SMT4 May 23rd, 2013, and I believe it came out in the U.S. July 16, 2013, so not too bad of a release. So I might have to bring it up. So that's like two or three months.
From what I've seen online, it came out in July in America, and came out in May in Japan. So
yeah, so, but there's also Persona 5, which is coming out during the summer, so they don't want to, clash with those.
Yeah, they don't want to mess up the 3DS sales.
Yeah, so,
I think what they're going to do is probably release in February, and we'll probably get this game in spring, maybe late spring, early summer. So it doesn't, and I think we're going to get Persona 5 in the winter, in America at least. Because it's coming out in summer for Japan, at least from what I've heard.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not too worried about the whole Persona 5 getting more sales than Shin Megami Tensei 4 Final if it does come out here in the summer, because I'm pretty sure Shin Megami Tensei 4 Final is going to come out probably early spring, late spring, since this game's probably going to come out in February, since this game's coming out in February in Japan. So
yeah. So another thing, speaking of SMT Fire Emblem, we might get something, probably an English trailer. Hopefully we can get.
I really want English, because I'm just sitting here, I'm like, wait, so we have a Crom persona weird thing. I don't know what to call them because they don't have a name at all.
It is Crom, I think.
Yeah, I know it's Crom, but is it like a persona or
like,
it's kind of weird because it's more based on Shin Megami Tensei. Well, Shin Megami Tensei in general, but I think they're gonna go more for the Persona vibe in a way.
Yeah, I think there is a name, but I don't really know, like off the top of my head. Like I know I seen it in the video, but I can't get it into my head.
Right now, I want to call Crom a persona, just like as a placeholder name for at least, because I've never really played Shin Megami Tensei except for Nocturne, so I think they're called demons, if I'm right, demons.
Yeah, they're demons in the SMT world.
Yeah, in the SMT world at least, but this game kind of reminds me more of a Persona game because of the vibe I get for Persona 4. This game just reminds me of Persona 4 for some reason, because Persona 4 was quote unquote a lot more lighthearted than Persona 3. So I'm kind of getting a Persona 4 vibe from this game. So I kind of want to call them Personas for now. So,
and
I really hope we get an English trailer, to be honest.
Yeah, and hopefully you know the English name for it, because the Japanese name is like so freaking long, like Gingeki, like Sharp FE, something on lines of that. Hopefully.
I don't think there's an official name for Japan, at least.
Yeah, there is. Like, they already have the box art for it and everything.
Oh, is it still, like, called, like, Shin Megami?
No, like, it's, like, Genki Boku Sharp FE. That's, like, the name of it, I think. And
it
it's, like,
has the Fire Emblem FE.
Yeah. And it's coming out next month, I believe, for Japan.
Yeah, December.
Yeah.
If only I had a Japanese Wii U. That was my kind of my second prediction. Hope we get maybe a release window as well.
Yeah, the release window is 2016.
Yeah, I hope we get a release window. Maybe a few more characters, kind of like who their voice actors are gonna be. Is Crom? I hope Crom comes back. His voice actor for Crom comes back. One of the main characters gives me a Lucina vibe, but I'm pretty sure her quote unquote persona thing has nothing to do with Lucina.
Nah.
That's what I've like seen in trailers. Like the female main character, she gives me a Lucina vibe, but from our trailers, it doesn't say her persona in air quotes is not Lucina. So.
Yeah. And like speaking like English voice actors, they gotta get people who can sing too. So like, because that's what they're doing with the Japanese voice acting for the game.
Yeah, it's a pop star game in a way.
Yeah. Like I can kind of think of a voice actor Vic Mignogna, because he is known for singing and he has released his own albums. Maybe I can imagine him voicing either the main character or the redheaded dude. Maybe
the redheaded dude's is it a summon, or because they showed him in the past writing his persona. I really don't want to say persona, but writing his thing.
Like, I believe like it's Kane or something like that. K-A-I-N-E, I think. I'm not sure.
So I kind of want them to explain the whole fusion thing. I don't want to call it. I don't know a name for it, because we haven't got a lot of info for this game except for E3, but that's like all Japanese stuff.
Yeah.
So I kind of want to see Nintendo and Atlas kind of explain the whole work together thing with your personas. I hope we get an official name for America at least, of like what the things are, because I don't want to say persona for this whole video. It's like persona. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I really hope they explain a lot, because we haven't gotten a lot of news here, but Japan's gotten a lot of news there since the game's like almost out.
Yep. Okay, so my next prediction, it's something involving Super Smash Bros. They're gonna have to tell us who won the Smash ballot. It's been well over a month now since they ended the Smash ballot, and rumor has it that apparently they're gonna have 6 characters and have 3 release after the Nintendo Direct.
I still have not bought Ryu, Roy, and
I got all of them.
Nintendo, please slow down.
Yeah, like we have no idea who won. We have no idea what else might come at from this. So.
Yeah, I definitely think they're gonna pull another E3 one, like put all like 3 characters in the same. 3 characters that were released at the same time. So.
I really hope Sora comes in here.
I really hope we get another third-party character.
Yeah.
Like, at least one more.
People say, oh, bring my old characters. Like, how about a new character for a new game, huh? It's like, eh. Not like more clones and, you know, whatnot.
Wolf. I've seen all that so much. Free Wolf.
Wolf.
I think... I don't know how popular opinion this is, but I think we could get something from Splatoon, more Splatoon content from first Smash Bros. At least.
Yeah.
Stage. Because I kind of want to have an inked Tropolis. I think it's called Tropolis. Kind of want to have at least one Splatoon stage because Super Mario Maker received a stage, and that stage is pretty badass. Yeah, it's pretty cool. So.
You can go.
Oh yeah. I don't know how they're gonna do it, but it'll be. I hope it's kind of like a Pokemon, the Light Tower from X and Y. I haven't played Pokemon X and Y, but there's a stage in Smash Bros. 3DS where you kind of go around the region. Well, not the region, but the city, the main city. So I hope we get something like that with Inktopolis, and I think it's gonna be only a Wii U stage or.
So a traveling stage.
Yeah, kind of like a traveling stage. That's what I want.
Yeah, like there's also people wanting, you know, like with the Inklings in Smash, like
yes, Splatoon.
Yeah.
I don't know how they're gonna do it, but I would love at least a stage, more representation, since we already have the Mii fight, the Mii costumes.
Yeah. And I believe we might get more stages as well. Probably maybe from what's it called? Star Fox Zero, maybe?
Oh. Maybe. I think we already have a lot of Star Fox stages.
Yeah, like...
We have Corneria and... For the... Corneria, and we also have the new one. Transcendental... No. Something like a... Orbital Gate or something.
Yeah, I think it's called that.
Yeah. So we basically have 2 stages for Wii U, 1 stage for the 3DS, so... I mean, I know Mario has a lot of stages, and Legend of Zelda also has a lot of stages. But, yeah, I feel like more stages the better.
Mm-hmm. More options for people.
Yeah. But I want it to be more unique.
Mm-hmm. And, what's your prediction? No.
I've heard a lot about Shovel Knight for the past few weeks, and people won't shut up about Shovel Knight. No offense to anyone that's actually hoping for Shovel Knight. It's just, I don't know. There are some, like, articles out there saying that Shovel Knight's sales are actually 50% from the Wii U's, like, consoles. So that's pretty cool to hear. So I think it has something to do with, like, oh, this feels like an old school game, like DuckTales or Mega Man. So if they do add Shovel Knight, it'd be really interesting because Shovel Knight gets a lot of sales from Nintendo consoles, which I find pretty interesting. So I'm personally hoping for Shovel Knight. I think if some of the characters that kind of quote unquote were in the top 10, we may get Mii costumes instead because we kind of got that with Lloyd.
Yeah.
From
Lloyd, no.
Lloyd and King K. Rool.
So. Yeah. And Crom.
Oh yeah, Crom. Yeah, I don't think Crom's gonna be in Smash. Yeah. I know
that would be another clone, most likely.
Yeah, basically gonna be. We have. It's basically gonna be an Ike clone. It's basically.
I thought, like maybe in like Marth, Lucina, and Kron would be the three clones.
Yeah, Roy came back from Melee Clone. Lucina's a clone of Marth. So. To be honest, I don't want another Fire Emblem character, but.
Yeah, I mean, either.
I think Kron should just say a Final Smash and a Mii costume. But I did like Robin, he was very unique. I completely understand why Sakurai wanted Robin instead of Kron. But Lucina was an alternate costume for Marth. Then she became her whole own character. And that's what happened with Dark Pit and Dr. Mario. And to be honest, I play a lot more Dark Pit than Pit. So I don't know why. I have this like inside feeling that Pit, like Dark Pit's like stronger. But...
So I want to see Shantae in Smash.
Oh,
like
Shantae.
Yes.
I actually forgot about her.
Yeah, she's been in with Nintendo longer than Shovel Knight. She's more, personally, I think she's more memorable than Shovel Knight. Like,
I think she, I would technically call her a quote unquote underground game, like an indie game in a way.
Like she started on like with
know,
the game.
She started on the Game Boy, and I think she's gonna stay on the Game Boy, on Nintendo. She doesn't have any games on other consoles, right? Because I'm pretty sure they're all Nintendo. Like they're all on Nintendo.
There's some on PC, and
oh yeah, PC ports at least.
And I think I'm not sure, but like on PS3 or PS4, I think I'm not sure. Like I believe it was Risky Boots Revenge. That's on the other consoles. She would be a new character. She's getting, represented like and technically what's it called? Being promoted for her new game coming out like next year, I think.
I'm pretty sure it's next year.
Yeah, Half Genie Hero. And like that would be a great way to promote it.
So one of Shantae's games, Shantae's Risky's Revenge, actually came on the PS4 over the summer, actually.
Yeah.
Didn't know that. And actually Shantae's game, The Pirate Curse, and Shantae and the Pirate's Curse only came on a 3DS and Wii U, and there was a PC port.
Yeah.
So there's technically only been one Shantae game where she's been off Nintendo consoles. So I'm pretty sure Shantae has the chance.
Yeah.
In technicalities, I would call her a second-party character.
So. Yeah, well, like they work real close with Nintendo, but they also done development or
they a bunch of development for Capcom. I know that.
Yeah.
They work really close, not really close, but they work close with Capcom because of the whole DuckTales thing.
Yeah, DuckTales. I was thinking about it. I'm looking over at my games, list, trying to see who else could come in Smash. Like,
more Xenoblade. Personally, I think Xenoblade. Like, I hope Xenoblade Chronicles X gets some representation in Smash.
Maybe as a stage.
Or a stage, or a whole new character, because this game is actually very different from Xenoblade Chronicles, and we're not gonna have another Shulk. We're not gonna have another Shulk one, basically.
Well, we haven't really seen like any other characters from Xenoblade Chronicles X besides that one woman.
I think we're gonna get the main character, but I think they're gonna pull a Atlas. This is a weird term, but I think they're gonna have a canon name for him and a canon look for him.
Or like
he gets introduced in Smash. Monolith Soft may pull an Atlas here and give an official name for the main character, which can be a boy or girl. So, no problem.
Oops, sorry about that. Okay. So, I was thinking, like, they might do, maybe a Olimar thing where they had, a male and female, not male and female, but, like, they're Olimar and, what's his name?
Alf.
Yeah, Alf. And, well, like, when we switch over for costumes.
Yeah, that's a problem, because...
And, like, Robin, female Robin, male Robin.
Yeah, Xenoblade Chronicles X is gonna be like a quote unquote Final Fantasy game where each game is like very different from the last. So, but they're gonna still have like a few things from Xenoblade Chronicles, the original Xenoblade Chronicles. They're gonna have some. They're gonna have the race. I forgot what's Riki's race. I think it's called Napan or something. That's confirmed to be back. This takes place on a thing. This concept of New Earth. Yeah. So in a way, this technically takes place in the real world compared to Xenoblade Chronicles, which takes place on an alternate universe. Like a weird alternate universe thing.
Well, we can transport ourselves over to Xenoblade and Chronicles X as another prediction to see.
I hope we get a release date.
We already have a release.
I'm stupid. I mean,
just get the final trailer. So
yeah, probably one more trailer. Just to say blah blah blah. Thank you guys for supporting the game.
DLC. Maybe.
Maybe free DLC. I don't know. I don't know why I said release date. I was like, oh guys, we're gonna get a release date.
Is there any pre-order bonuses that they haven't, like,
announced? I know it's a special edition.
I think it was, like, art book or something like that.
I know there's, like, a soundtrack. I think there's a CD. I really want to say statue of the robot. The robots, like, the mechas you can use in the game, but I'm pretty sure it's not. Let me actually look that up right now, because you know it's, like, kind of goes X special edition. Not
really
special, bro. Special.
No, like I just saw like on Facebook on Chugga Conroy's Facebook, and he already has his copy of Xenoblade Chronicles X from Nintendo.
Yeah, he's reviewing it.
Or already selling Let's Play on it.
Okay, Amazon's not selling it. That's weird. I think it's a GameStop exclusive, isn't it? Okay, no, Best Buy is showing it off.
Huh.
Okay, it comes with a USB drive.
Oh, yeah.
A Xenoblade Chronicles X themed hard drive.
And I believe it also comes with its soundtrack in there, I believe.
Yeah, soundtrack.
Yeah.
Okay, art book. Custom soundtrack on the custom USB and a art card.
Okay.
And it comes in like one of those like SH figure art boxes. It looks like one of those SH figure arts boxes. Actually, going back to Splatoon, I think we could get more expansive content. I think more DLC, kind of like weapons and stuff.
Yeah, the Octo. The Octolings.
Because apparently data mines have been found for the Octolings.
Mm-hmm. And weapons and all that.
Yeah, weapons are kind of the usual. I don't think we're going to get any new weapon classes for a while. Because we recently just got the Splasher and the Heavy Splatling. Which were two amazing weapon classes. I honestly prefer the Splasher. I know that Tri-Slasher is coming soon. So, I honestly hope we get more single-player campaign. To be honest, I really liked the campaign. It was really, like, cute. And I really liked the final boss, which was DJ.
DJ Octo. Or something like that.
I just loved his music.
Can you feel the bass? Yeah. Or something like that. I don't know.
One was like a dubstep one. I'm gonna dubstep all over your face or something.
Yeah.
That's really. It was really funny. And as like a fan of electronic music, I really appreciate that. I laughed a bit.
Wub wub wub.
Wubble wub.
Okay, so I think.
We haven't talked about 3DS, have we?
Well, a little bit with the SMT4 final, and I was about to say we might get some more info about Mario and Luigi Paper Jam.
Oh yeah. Apparently, yeah. It's gonna release in America later.
Yeah.
Because they did this with Mario Luigi Dream Team. They also recently did this with Yoshi Woolly World.
Which is kind of dumb.
I just thought of something. More amiibos.
Maybe for DLC characters for Smash. That's what I'm thinking.
They're probably. I hope they confirm the release date for Ryu, Roy, and Lucas. Mewtwo's already coming out soon. I think coming out this week. I know Pokemon Mystery Dungeon is coming soon.
Yep, probably another trailer. So,
Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival. They're gonna advertise that.
Yeah.
Mario Tennis to Ultra Smash. That's gonna be obvious.
Maybe we could get another Mario Kart 8 DLC.
DLC pack? Splatoon?
I don't know what they could do with that, but it's kind of been dead for a little while. They could use something to bring it back up.
It's also the holiday season, so I hope they bring something back. Yeah, because I actually have not touched Mario Kart 8 in so long.
Yeah.
After the last one came out, I think it was the Villager Pack. I have not touched it since I played it online for a bit and I stopped.
Yeah, but they're doing the Super Smash Bros. Splatoon Wii U combo, so.
Oh, that was amazing.
That is a good deal, but.
I really don't think we're gonna get, I think Smash 4 is gonna have longer support.
Yeah, because it's Smash.
With the whole DLC thing. I think we're gonna get more characters over time, and eventually with the NX. I don't really know how they're going to deal with Smash 5. Sakura said multiple times that it may be his last game, and
That's what they all said, but they keep on coming back for more.
Yeah, I don't know. So, I really hope for Smash 5, but yeah, it's like a 2018-20 discussion. I honestly hope for, let's see. I think I just forgot. It was in the back of my mind. But maybe talk more about Pokemon Go.
They I believe if you go to the Nintendo Direct site, they say they won't be talking about the NX or mobile games.
Oh, that's okay. Oh well. Or maybe they could show a teaser for the new for Animal Crossing Wii U. I mean, it could still be a possibility. Because the assets for Amiibo Festival, Happy Home Designer, it looked pretty good, and we already have a lot of Animal Crossing Amiibo cards and actual Amiibos, so they could pull a plot twist saying, "Hey guys, we have some Animal Crossing Wii U footage," and because to be honest, I did not like E3. Nintendo didn't really do a good E3.
Yeah.
The whole Samus. What was that game called?
Metroid Prime 10 Federation Force.
Oh, that's so much hate behind that.
If you don't want it, don't buy it. Easy as that.
Yeah, I know. Maybe a release date or more footage.
Or maybe they just read it all together, just remade it all together to make it, oh, hey, we changed a lot of stuff. Ever since E3.
Retro Studios have been saying in the past they're working on something, but they have not told us at all. So I hope it's not another Donkey Kong title, even though they're pretty good. I really hope it's going to be a full-on new Metroid title, because I actually want to get into the Metroid series. I also hope they do HD, a virtual console port of the Metroid trilogy.
I think they already did for the Wii U.
They did? Oh, yeah. I'm so behind.
And I have the first Metro Prime. Good thing I found them, $30 altogether, I think.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. I'm currently going through two right now. And so good. I don't know why I haven't played them when I had a GameCube. It's so good. Maybe they could show off, you know. They might have another Metroid game, like, at this Nintendo Direct. Because, like, I remember, like, I believe last year at the Video Game Awards, or a year before, Reggie had that Metroid Prime, or that Metroid pin on him. So, we don't know.
Random segue, but I honestly don't think they're gonna show Zelda Wii U.
I kind of think they will.
I honestly don't think it's gonna happen.
Like, they haven't.
I think this is gonna be an NX game, an NX Wii U game, just like how they did Twilight Princess.
They said they're not gonna talk about the NX, so.
I know, but if they don't talk about Zelda Wii U for now, they're probably gonna do an E3 thing where it's like, oh, this is gonna be an NX Wii U game now. And they kind of have like a launch title, one of the launch titles for the NX. And NX is going to be talked about next year, right?
Yeah, next year. Okay,
so, if they don't talk about Zelda at all, then I'm most likely going to be able to, that E3 is going to happen.
Well, they also have the Game Awards next month, which they, you know, showed off gameplay last year, too.
Barely. I don't know. It's not good gameplay. To be honest, in my opinion, that was not good enough.
They showed off the open world and, you know, exploration a little bit, and some of the enemies. Now we gotta see, you know, some more characters, plot, all that.
I wonder if they're, maybe they could,
Maybe, you know, like, if when they announce the Twilight Princess HD, it comes with a demo for, Zelda Wii U.
I think it's gonna be another physical game, right? I think it's gonna be physical, like, not a, I was about to say digital game, but I'm like, eh. I think that's gonna limit sales a bit, but I think a physical version of the game is gonna be so much better.
Yeah, like, they barely release, you know, digital games, like...
I just remember something about Zelda. They're re-releasing Hyrule Warriors, right?
Yeah, Hyrule, for the 3DS.
And apparently, if you sync it over to the Wii, you get all the new fighters.
Yeah.
Warriors. So that's pretty cool. I hope they talk about Hyrule Legends more, because I did play a bit of the Wii version. I was kind of like, eh, it's alright. Yeah. I've played so many Warrior games made by that company. Koei Tecmo? No.
Koei Tecmo.
I played so many games, so I feel like the genre of the game got really stale for me. So, I'm just sitting here like, maybe Hyrule Warriors Legends may bring me back in, because I did like it a bit, but I'm not really a Zelda person, so maybe that's why I wasn't really interested in the whole Warriors concept again, because my childhood is basically all of those games. I was like, I'm getting tired of this, I kinda need a break.
Hey, we might get that female Link that's been in that,
Linka?
What? I don't know.
I think her name's Linkle. She was
holding, yeah. Hopefully, and maybe some, like, people get mad, just like, why is there a female Link? This is not right.
She's technically her own canon, so. Yeah.
Her own character in Hyrule Warriors.
I don't know why people are arguing about that.
They're like, hey, it's just one character, what's it gonna do? Like, it does everything!
I hope we get more characters for, Hyrule Legends, because I like the ones we got so far. Toon Link, Tetra.
Yeah. Her name, yeah, Tetra.
Tetra.
King Red.
Hyrule, basically.
And Skull Kid. Again, Skull Kid.
Skull Kid! The moon! Skull Kid. I'm most likely going to be Skull Kid, because he looks so badass. I'm like, yeah!
Bring down the moon.
I'm happy I got the new 3DS XL version. I had the new 3DS XL, so that's gonna look so good on me. It's gonna look so good on that console.
Yep.
What do you think we're gonna get on the Wii Virtual Console next? The whole Wii, the porting to the Wii.
Well, I never had a Wii, so I'm just thinking, maybe we could get. Well, there's rumors saying about Skyward Sword being part of the virtual console, Wii U Virtual.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
One thing I'm mad at is Wii Sports. They ruined Wii Sports. They ruined Wii Sports with the whole free-to-play thing. I was like, they ruined boxing. It was so good back then. I used to be the master of boxing. Good times.
I kind of want to see the Trauma Center games on there, for some reason.
Oh yeah, they are doing DS games now, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I totally forgot about that.
Maybe we could get some Pokemon games on there? Maybe. Yeah,
maybe Pokemon Ruby, Sapphire, you know, more Game Boy games on there.
Like, they could do that for the 3DS, since there's the Pokemon Bank system, but, like, that would be a lot of reworking.
I don't know how Nintendo's gonna work on that, because Pokemon, it's gonna have, Pokemon Banks are gonna be fun.
Yeah.
Okay, this is kind of random, super, super out of the blue, F-Zero.
I heard there might be a F-Zero X 3D, I think it's called, for the 3DS. I'm not sure.
Oh, maybe Super Mario Galaxy 3. Okay, now I'm just gonna move on to, like, random.
Maybe. Like, oh, Pikmin 4. They, like, I believe.
Oh, yeah, they announced.
They didn't really, like, announce it, but, like, I think, like, Miyamoto said.
It's like, oh, yeah, we're working on it.
We're, it's almost done.
It's almost done, but it may be end next year.
Like, I'm kind of thinking maybe it could be on the 3DS. I'm not sure. Like, I'm kind of thinking wild guess that, like, it kind of seems too soon for another Pikmin game.
If it's gonna be a 3DS title, I think it's gonna be a new 3DS X, new 3DS title only.
Why?
I don't know. It's just I know the 3DS has power, but I honestly think.
Stop excluding us.
I think that was Xenoblade, but.
How about Pokken Tournament? We haven't got anything about that.
They said spring 2016 worldwide release.
Are you sure?
Yeah. They said that somewhere in the interview. They said 2016 worldwide release. Because it's not actually like a Pokemon. Wait, did X and Y get a worldwide release?
Yeah.
And also the remix?
No, I don't think they got a world.
Okay. I know Bandai Namco is developing this, so I'm pretty sure. From what I've heard, it's not rumors. I remember this is like confirmed somewhere, but they said it's gonna have a worldwide spring 2016 release date for Wii U. So that's what I currently remember. I don't remember my source, but heard it somewhere. I know it's confirmed.
Oh, Pokemon Z. We could. Pokemon Z?
I think that's gonna be next year.
Like, they could announce it now, and, like, have it, like, for summer 2016.
That's gonna break Game Freak's usual announcement time for Pokemon. Because Game Freak has a certain, from one of my friends told me, they were, like, Pokemon Fanatics. But they basically said Game Freak has, like, a certain time they announce their main Pokemon series or whatever they want to work on. And they give it a few months of hype, talk more about it at E3, blah, blah, blah. And then it gets released near the holiday season. So I honestly think that's going to happen. Since we're on a subject, Pokemon Snap for the Wii U, eh?
Pokemon Snap 2, the long-awaited game.
I think I, if it's gonna be one of those, I think it's gonna be a downloadable only title.
Yeah. You know, it would be cool to have Pokemon Snap on 3DS. Just like, that would be perfect.
Or have two versions. Have the Wii version and a 3DS version. Where you can cross-play. Like, you can have a... Like,
with Pokemon Go.
Oh, yeah. I don't know how they're gonna do that.
I don't know, it's just coming out of the top of my head.
I think you're gonna do a cross-platform thing where you can have a split-screen versus, where whoever takes the better pictures of Pokemon, like whoever takes the better picture of Mewtwo or Charizard, they get like more points. I think that's gonna split-screen versus would be pretty cool for a Pokemon Snap.
Yeah. We can get new info about Fire Emblem Fates. That's another thing.
Oh yeah, I hope they didn't they announce a third campaign?
No.
I know there's the peaceful side.
There's Birthright and Conquest and like Conquest. some downloadable thing.
There's a new one called Invisible Kingdom where you say screw both of you.
I've never heard that.
That's in Japan only right now. That's the DLC. It's called Invisible Kingdom. It's the DLC. It's a DLC journey. Basically, it's a whole game, but without any alliances. So you basically go on your own, saying, "I want to make my own kingdom. I'm gonna take over both of you." So it's kind of, in a way, you will call it a quote unquote neutral ending. I mean, a neutral game. So.
Like we can finally hear more of the English voices, like. I want to see Camilla, whatever her name is. Pink hair girl, purple hair.
I just realized.
What?
Super Mario Maker DLC. Could be a possibility.
But they recently did that update, and they recently did like an update today where they had a new costume release.
Well, those are amiibo. Those are event costumes. So, I mean, I hope we get. I want slopes. Slopes. Because Mario has slopes. Why we no slopes?
More power ups.
Oh yeah, we need way more power ups.
Yeah.
I'm just sitting here, it's like, where's my helicopter mushroom? Where's my penguin? Where's my ice flower?
We already have the chopper.
Wii U version, like the Wii U stage. I know about that. I think it would have been cool to see it in like Super Mario World or something.
Trying to think now, trying to see on my 3DS list. Move out of the way games. Not sure if you play this, but the Bravely Default games, Bravely Second. We haven't heard anything about that.
We heard nothing. I really want to play the first one, but I heard that I'm not really. I'm a scrub who's making RPGs, like super hard RPGs.
Yeah, I'm barely playing. It's like kind of long and it's like kind of tedious at the same time. Just like, I want to play, but it's like it's too much the same thing. like we have heard anything from Square Enix about it, like nothing. I'm not even sure if it's been released in Japan yet or has it.
I think Bayonetta is gonna be a Nintendo IP from now on.
Bayonetta 3?
Yeah, I think I don't think we're gonna Bayonetta 3.
Or the wonderful 102.
Platinum Games. I think they're gonna move on. If they do any more, I think it's gonna be more of an NX game. Thanks to Nintendo, Bayonetta 2 actually happened.
Yep.
I personally have never played Bayonetta because of the whole, you know.
I am. It's pretty good.
Yeah, sex thing. So I. But I found it pretty cool that Nintendo was completely fine with a rated M game beyond the Wii U. They're trying to appeal to a more open audience. So that's why I was like, wow, Bayonetta, an actual rated M game, actually made it to the Wii U.
Resident Evil Revelations.
No one really played that, right?
A lot of people have.
I heard they played more of the PS4, PS3, and PS4 and the Xbox version.
Don't know why the second game hasn't released on the Wii U. You know that's where it technically started.
I don't think sales did so well on the Wii version, from what I heard. I don't think the Nintendo versions did as well as the re-releases.
The 3DS sold a lot. That's why they did their HD remasters for.
Then they announced Revelations 2, which was more episodic, and I found that really stupid.
Yeah.
I don't know what Capcom was doing there.
I don't know.
I've heard rumors of Minecraft, apparently.
Oh, yeah, Minecraft on the Wii U.
That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah.
I mean, I used to play games. I used to play Minecraft a lot, but...
Oh.
I mean, it'd be pretty cool if you got it on there. Also, Terraria. Because there's a bunch of Minecraft ripoffs on there right now. John Cena for Smash.
John Cena!
Cena! His name is John Cena! Phoenix Wright for Smash?
Oh, speaking of Phoenix Wright.
Oh, yeah, the new Phoenix Wright game. Yeah.
But I'm kind of disappointed that we're not getting the great Ace Attorney, the one that takes place like way in the past.
Wait, we're not?
No, I don't think so, because I believe it's already been released.
In Japan, at least. I think we're gonna.
We're seven. I believe this is the seventh one.
The seventh one's the main series. The one that you're referring to, the I think that takes place in the past.
Yeah. We're not getting that, but I think hopefully we're getting seven.
I totally thought we would get that.
Because
it looked pretty cool.
Yeah, like it's a lot more interesting with that twist of being in the past.
And with the new one, it takes place in a whole new country that we don't even know what's called.
Takes place in China or something like that.
It looks. I always thought the Phoenix Wright games took place in America.
Oh, it's Ace Attorney 6, not 7.
Oh, CS6. Yeah, I always thought Phoenix Wright took place on like America kind of walls. That's what I thought. And they're apparently with Ace Attorney 6, they're calling this country or whatever. They don't even have a name for it.
Oh, we could see Project Cross Zone 2.
Oh, yeah. It's already out in Japan, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
Project X Zone 2. I played a bit of the first one. I wasn't really interested in it. I didn't really like the fighting mechanics of it.
Yeah, well, that's what kind of turned, like, some people off about it.
Was Mega Man in the original?
I think I'm not sure which version. I'm not sure if it's X or just regular Mega Man.
Because I know X is in... I know Zero is in there. Then I'm pretty sure X is in there. Because I remember seeing... I think I saw Jeff for the second one or first one. I'm probably getting my stuff confused, but I'm pretty sure I saw Mega Man one of them. So. I hope we get more Sega characters. Maybe get that Sonic.
I'm not sure. Like, it looks pretty full, the cast. Like, they recently add Crom, Lucina, and, like, the two Xeno characters.
I think it's only one.
There's two Xeno characters. Fiora and from Zeo Saga, I think.
Oh, wait, Zeno Saga is made by... Wait, let me see. Xeno.
Like, it's a blue-haired girl. Who's similar to Fiona?
Okay, I know it's Crom and Lucina. That's the Fire Emblem characters. I'm pretty sure it's only one Xeno.
No, I saw a trailer. There's two Zetos.
Yeah, it's only Lucina, Crom, and Fiora. Why not Shulk? Why? Wait, Fiora. Oh, they're using spoilers, Fiora. Are you serious? Ugh. You're using spoilers, Fiona. From like halfway through the game. Okay, I know a lot of people didn't get to play Xenoblade because the game's not exclusive, but I don't know why they Fiora. It could have been Shulk. I mean, come on.
Okay, I found the article.
It was wide open. I mean, come on. Why no Shulk, boy? I'm really feeling it. I see the Xeno Saga character now.
Yeah. Like,
she's a guest character.
Yeah, I see in here.
She's a guest character.
Okay. Like,
this really sucks. I really want a Shulk.
Hey, you got Smash. That's already a crossover game.
I know. But Project X Zone 2 basically spoiled Xenoblade Chronicles.
Meh.
They spoiled Fiora.
Meh.
No, that's a big spoiler.
Meh.
That's like really big.
Meh.
It's like damn, how do you know about this? Well, I actually seen the playthrough, so you can shut up.
Meh.
So, to be honest, with people that never want to play Xenoblade and want to play it now, it really disappoints people out there. Wait, Atlas is owned by Capcom, right?
No, Sega.
I mean, Sega. You know what I'm thinking of?
You would not call me!
Sonic characters!
And, but they were literally had bring Alice into this. As well, you know, like, when they brought a monolith soft into this and Nintendo.
Let's make this the biggest crossover game ever. Give me that. Come on, Atlas. Maybe.
It won't be bigger than Smash.
Give us a preview of Persona 5.
Persona 5 for Wii U.
Oh, that'd be a super plot twist. Like, hey, we're releasing Persona 5 for Wii U.
Yeah.
That'd be a really big plot twist.
Like, no, Vita, sorry, we're not bringing Persona 5 to you.
I don't know why. I don't even know why people brought the idea of Persona 5 to the Vita.
Because of the past history of the Persona games?
Yeah, I know. Almost all the Persona series is on the Vita now.
But, like, the better version.
Except Persona 4 Arena!
The better versions of the Persona games are on the Vita.
Okay, yeah, we don't talk about Persona 3 Portable.
Hey, that was my first Persona game, and I love it. I tried playing the Fez.
I really don't like how it's, like, all basically a mobile game.
I don't like Fez because, like, it feels slow. That's why, like, it feels way too slow.
Well, yeah, Persona...
And the combat,
Combat was kind of similar, to be honest. I already played a bit of Persona 3 Portable and Persona 3. The combat's kind of similar.
Yeah, but I'd rather take control of my characters and then let the computer take control. Like, Markarn! Markarn!
Yeah, it's usually 8% of three because you can't control your allies.
That's why I prefer Persona 3 Portable to Persona 3.
I'll never understand why Persona Q made it to the studio. I've never understood that.
I don't know why they haven't made Monaco a canon. Sheesh. The Fiend.
Oh, she's not supposed to be canon.
Why? They made Theo canon, but they can't make Monaco. That's not fair.
Oh, Theodore. That's a weird exception. I don't know.
That little wimp is part of Persona history, but not Monaco.
But that would really mess up the whole canon of Persona 3.
Alternate universe.
Yeah, I know, but...
Alternate universe.
I understand why Theo technically canon, because he's the younger brother of Elizabeth and Margaret, so...
Which they made for P3P. Ah.
And he's also canon Persona 4 Arena Ultimax.
Ah. Why?
Off topic from Nintendo, but we need another Persona 4 Arena like port. I really want a PS4 and Vita port. Because this is really good off topic, but seriously, because the developers, the Arc Systems, they made Blaze Blue for the Vita. They made most of the new Blaze Blue games are all on the Vita. And a PSP. Guilty Gear also had a bunch of PSP games. I mean, come on, Atlas. You want to make more money, right? It's wide open. Xbox One, PS4, Vita version. percent of arena. Just do it. And include all the DLC. Kind of call it the Ultimax Edition. The Ultimate Edition, whatever.
Okay, we're getting off topic here.
Yeah, I'm sorry, that's just a micro rant I have. Atlas, please.
Oh. Well, I was kind of thinking, we might see, speaking of Atlas, Double Survivor 3. Even though it's kind of early, since Double Survivor 2 recently came out during the summer.
Wait, how long did it come out?
Like, I'm gonna say July or August.
Oh, wow. I thought it was earlier.
Mm.
That was the remake, right?
The remake for the DS, which is awesome. And I barely got through. I'm not even that far into the game, even though I got like a few weeks after release.
Is it more of a Shin Megami Tensei title or more Persona like?
It has the concept of an SMT, but I'm saying it's kind of like Fire Emblem, like it's a strategy RPG, like where you have to like move the character to like a certain place and then you attack. Yeah. But like they still have like the concept of like Nocturne, where like you control the demons and like that. But everyone's human.
Seriously, don't know why. Okay. For more Persona.
Well, we could see another trailer for Star Fox Zero.
I hope it comes out early 2016, because to be honest, it was one of those hype games for me for the Wii U this year, but and it's gone. That's basically what it was, and it's gone.
Yeah.
Thanks, Miyamoto, and it's gone.
Mm.
Did they delay during E3, or was it after E3?
After E3.
Okay. They're like, and it's gone. Bye.
Mm.
I don't think we're gonna get another mainstream Mario game for a while.
DLC for Mario Ultra Smash.
oh, please. Did you see how much content they have in that game so far?
Oh, it's a lot. Oh, it's so much. Do you not see all that content? Do you not see all that content? Do you see all those one power ups?
Oh, like that giant mushroom power up.
Uh huh. And that other giant mushroom power up.
Okay, Nintendo. I think they just want Mario Tennis to survive for generations. So they're just doing it. It's like, oh, it's still living. We're gonna make a better version of it next. Bye.
Yeah, like I'm pretty sure they won't talk about the NX, but like they might say, "Oh, we're still working on the NX." Just like, "Oh, we'll talk more in 2016."
Oh, they recently announced Dragon Quest for the 3DS, right? The new one.
Yeah, I think.
Maybe they could do coverage on that tomorrow.
Maybe, but like it's still very early in development, so.
Maybe you could get something. But here's the. The annoying thing, they're probably gonna have to mention the NX version if that's actually real. I guess Square Enix is like, oh, we're probably working on an NX version. We don't know yet. Yeah. That's the whole rumor that it's gonna be as powerful as the PS4 Xbox One thing. So.
Hmm.
Yeah, I honestly don't have any more predictions because.
Yeah. That's yeah. No, like I'm kind of drawing blank. I'm trying to look at. Maybe Kid Icarus, a sequel.
Maybe another one. Maybe a new 3DX XL one. Exclusivity.
Yeah. Like the success of Uprising, but like it could take Sakurai a lot out of it though. Working on the DLC for Smash and a new Kid Icarus game.
I hope someone else. picks up Kid Icarus. If Sakurai still working on Smash, I hope someone else picks it up inside Nintendo. I don't know who is gonna do it.
It's gotta be by Sakurai. Like, it's technically his baby now.
I know Sakurai did really well, but I think someone could pick it up.
Like who?
I don't know any. I don't really know my developers. I know Miyamoto and the other guy that works on Mario. I don't know the Zelda developer at all.
Maybe Zelda
developer could do something. I don't know.
Well, I think Hajime talked about say like oh like the director of I think the director of Final Fantasy 15. He said, "Oh, theory like hypothetically, I would like to work on a Zelda game." She's like, "Hey, that'd be cool." But like, oh, have like open
didn't
world.
Wasn't there like a super? I think it's Oracle of Time. Yep. Like, a long time ago, that was actually a Capcom. It's called the Triforce development team. We were basically three companies working on it. Nintendo, I think it was Sega and Capcom, because Capcom wanted to completely remake the original Zelda. So.
I don't know. Yeah, I can't think of anything now, so wanna end it off here?
Yeah, I guess, because I honestly have nothing else to say.
Yeah, so I like thank you guys for watching. I like thank my guest here, Nam, for joining me. And
no problem.
Fortunately, we can have other people join, but they're lost.
Yeah, I got to say what I wanted to say, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe more games for the Nintendo 3DS XL, because they said there's gonna be exclusive titles, but yeah, hasn't really happening. Oh wait, maybe they can show more of Monster Hunter Ultimate. Whatever they want to do with that.
I think that they already released like their last free DLC pack.
Well, that's for Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate. There was gonna be one called Monster Hunter X, I think, like a spinoff, not actually like a main game.
Maybe.
Oh, it's Oracle of Ages, and we're supposed to see.
So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Nan, why don't you tell them where they can find you?
So my YouTube channel is Nantastic. Power Guy will probably link it most likely down below. I call him Power Guy. Yeah.
Maybe I'll forget.
Yeah. Find me at Nantastic. Nantastic. It's NamTaskic.
Yep. So I like thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, favorite share with all your friends. Check out links in the description below. And I will see you guys in my next video. Power out.
That's been fantastic. Thank you guys for watching.
Yeah. Power out. Yeah.